Hello everyone, it is Alric from AppPlay here, and today we're going to be playing DomiNations, the latest game from the developer of Civilization 2 and Rise of Nations. So this is the original game designer of those two games. Now, supposedly this is very similar to Clash of Clans, but also Age of Empires. So I've been playing this for just a little bit here. I played past the tutorial because I knew you guys probably wouldn't want to watch that. But as you can see here, the graphics are amazing, and there are a lot of cool things to do within the game, such as hunting individual animals. So I can actually hunt the deer using some of these spearmen that I have here. As you can see, they are going off hunting some of the deer, and that creates food. And food is actually the resource that you use to train your troops. So I definitely think that's a very interesting mechanic there, that the food can actually be obtained by attacking some of these different animals, such as the stag, the deer, the bunnies that are all in this area here as well. So as you can see, there are different things to collect here. We have a gold mine, which we can mine gold with, but everything seems to be an individual action as opposed to things doing them as they go along. You actually have to do the action in order to get the resources, such as the gold, such as hunting down deer. Now, most likely what's gonna happen later on is it's gonna become a longer timer for an increased reward. So as you can see there, we had about 15 seconds and we were able to get around 200 gold, but it's making us wait a cooldown period of 10 minutes. So it is different than Clash of Clans. It's not exactly the same mechanics. Now, as you can see here, we do have our troop training area where we have some spearmen that we can train. Now, I currently have all 10 spearmen because, similar to Boom Beach, your spearmen actually survive. All of your troops survive. The battle will come back. So if they survive, they'll come back. So we've got a couple messages here, as you can see, welcoming us to the DomiNations game. Now, the very interesting thing about this game is you actually have a choice to choose between 7 different civilizations and having that impact your own civilization. So you actually choose what civilization you want to emulate. So there are different civilizations. We'll choose that as we go along. Now, of course, let me know what you think of this game in the comment section below if you want to see me continue playing it. But let's hop right in. Let's see what we can build here. So there is a blacksmith in the economy. Let's take a look at that. We have some roads. We'll build that in a second. I want to build a market here, see what we can purchase. So let's build that and finish that for free. And markets are going to allow us to store our gold, so we can upgrade that to store more gold. Okay, that makes more sense. So as you can see, we can store gold within the market here. Let's go back in. Let's take a look. Our defense. We can build another tower, very similar to the archer towers, and that's going to take a little while. We'll let our builders do that there. All right, let's go into battle and show you the battle mechanics. Now, unlike Clash of Clans and the 3-star system, it appears to be a 5-star system with some rewards. And right now, I'm just attacking non-player bases. However, eventually, you will be able to attack and form alliances with real players. But I have not exactly gotten to that point yet. So right now, I'm just in the beginning stages. So let's take a look here. As you can see, very similar setup to Clash of Clans. We have our troops that we can deploy in. Now, the cool thing is you can actually target them to one specific building. So obviously, I want to take out the defensive building, and so I target them to that. Now, troops do come in and start attacking you here, and you got to take out those troops as well. But any of my troops that survive will actually be able to come back home with me, very similar to the Boom Beach mechanics. And that was definitely something I liked in Boom Beach, so I'm glad that they took inspiration from that when they made this particular game by the developer of Civilization 2. So as you can see here, we are attacking pretty much their headquarters, their home base, town hall equivalent, and we just beat that. All right, so here is what you do to get 5 stars. The first is getting 50% damage will earn you 1 star, 75% damage will earn you another star, complete destruction will earn you a 3rd star, but then taking down the town center earns a star, and a quick victory, which I'm not exactly how that is defined, is also another star. And my surviving troops will come back as well, and I gain some loot, 400 gold and 400 food. And we lost 2 troops, unfortunately, but the other 8 troops will come back with us. So let's take a look here. So very similar to Clash of Clans, there's a tree that I can clear over there. I believe there's also some other things that I can clear over here as well. Now, the interesting thing is not only does it cost builders to clear, it also costs a certain amount of either your food or your gold to clear or perform a specific action, such as mining or clearing different items. So once those are done, I will show you over here. There's also the ability to get fruit from the fruit tree, which requires two builders. So not just one, you actually need two. So that's why I gotta wait for another builder to finish up here and get those going. Now they're actually, as you can see, if you click at the top here, it'll give you a little definition on how long it's gonna take for each of them to finish. So that is definitely an added bonus. So we're gonna go in just a second and attack again. Let's train up a couple more troops and just hope that that takes us only 1 minute. So we'll be right back once that finishes. So we have all of our troops trained up. Let's go and attack and battle again and see how this is going to pan out. Now obviously this is the beginning stages, so if you guys want to see me keep playing this game, of course let me know in the comment section below. Be sure to subscribe, it is much appreciated. And if any of you guys are new and just watching for the first time, once we hit some of those milestones like 1,000 subscribers, we're going to be giving out 5 $10 iTunes gift cards. Hit 2,000, we're going to be giving out another $50 iTunes gift card. And if we hit 5,000, we'll be giving out another $50 iTunes gift card on top of that. So be sure to subscribe and tell your friends. All right, let's send in these troops here, our spearmen, and we are definitely gonna target them to attack this this tower over here, and then we'll target them to attack. Oh, we have to wait because there is a cooldown for the targeting. As you can see, it's gonna be 24 seconds. It starts out at 30 until we can target again. So that definitely adds an additional strategic element to the game, which is definitely very interesting. The ability to target specific towers or specific defenses that they have, and that's definitely a very interesting addition to the game. As you can see, we're about to completely destroy the base here, and we have 5-starred this base and collected some resources. This is actually a lot of fun so far, and there is a lot of stuff to do. One of the things I definitely like about it is the ability to attack, or not attack, but hunt the various different animals that come along, such as the deer, in order to collect food. I think that that is a great addition, something to do when there's not a lot to do in the game, maybe when your troops are all training. That is something that you could do. So I do have all 10 troops there. They're marching in here. So actually we can go and attack another base here. So let's attack this base. And these are all non-players right now. So let's see if this gets a little trickier. All right, so it looks like, as you can see, there are two different entrances. And it looks like we have our two towers over here. Now, if I go in and I'm going to send in some of my guys at that tower, and there we go, and what I can do is target that tower. Now I'm going to target this tower, so they go over and attack the tower before going inside, because we don't want the tower to continue attacking them. So now they're attacking these enemies over here from a different tribe. Now, one of the things I think will happen, and what I think will be very interesting, is as you grow and as you progress through the different ages, because that's one of the things, you develop new technology, new resources, you go all the way up to the space age in this game, so all the other bases are going to progress in that nature. So instead of looking like little shacks, little huts, it's going to progress the point where it could be an intergalactic station or something of that nature. So that's what I'm definitely looking forward to with this game. So let's collect some of that loot. We've got our gold, we have all of our, we're attacking their main base here. As you can see, we're about to destroy that. And then we're gonna go and attack their food storages, and we're going to completely obliterate this base with 100% destruction. So overall, it is a lot of fun, I feel, playing this right now. It has a Clash of Clans feel, but it's not so close to Clash of Clans like some of those other games, that it still has that kind of depth to it as well. All right, so let's clear out another area here and see what we can find within it. It's gonna take about 30 seconds, but it lets me finish it for free. All right, we just found a temple thing. I'm not exactly sure what that is. See. Ruins. Let's explore these ruins and see what we will get. I am not sure what's gonna happen here. So we're just gonna wait and we'll be right back once that 40 seconds is up. All right, so the ruins are about to be finished here, and let's see what we get. We got crowns! So this is the equivalent of a gem box, it appears. As you can see, we got 25 crowns, which is the premium currency. So that is pretty cool. Now, this site now lies empty. Would you like to sell it for 250? So basically, it looks like you get this, and then you're able to sell it for crowns, and then you can sell it again, or unlock it for crowns, and you could sell it again. I'm gonna leave it there for now, because it looks pretty cool. But that looks like the equivalent of a gem box. That's a nice addition there. We're gonna unlock this little chest over here and see what's in it. We're also going to clear this small rock. Take a look at that there. A gold deposit that we can mine, so we'll mine that as well. So we have a lot of our various citizens working all at the same time. So there's definitely a lot to do in this game. I love the graphics. It definitely looks astounding right now. So hopefully they continue that on as you get into the higher levels. Overall, I am very impressed with the quality of this game. So we just got a good gold deposit here. We got some, we were able to clear the rock, get some cider for our food. All right, so we just trained up our troops there. Now I'm looking at this, and as you can see, there is a slinger. Now, I'm very interested in getting that slinger. So if I go to the store here and we go down to the blacksmith, it looks like we need 1,200 food. So I'm going to try and collect some food by attacking the next base or next town that we have. And I'm also going to try and collect some food by attacking some of these animals here at home. So we got the fox is going to get us some gold, apparently. But we do have that deer over there. Let's see if there's any more deer. All right, so we got our blacksmith going. We were able to collect enough food to get him going. And we are going to finish him here for some crowns. That way, we can actually get our new slingers. So research at the blacksmith. So we're gonna click on the blacksmith, click on research. Slingers here. Oh no, no, it's gonna require 1,000 more food. So unfortunately, we're gonna need to collect some more food here. Let's look around. We'll be right back once we collect that food. All right, so we now have our slingers researching, but I will speed that up for you guys for the sake of this video. So we're just gonna hit yes there. And hey, we already got some free temples that we found, ruins that we found earlier where we collected some free crowns. We might as well put them to good use. So now we can train up some slingers over here. And then I just realized right now that that also requires food. So I will get more food and then we'll go back and train up some of these troops. All right, so we have almost enough, actually no, exactly enough to upgrade Bronze Age. Now all I have to do is wait for my citizens to be done with what they're doing, with their attacking and whatnot. And now we're gonna be able to upgrade our town center for 3,500 gold. So we're just gonna press that right there. And in recognition of your civilization's growing power, neighboring tribes send emissaries to bear tribute. Okay, let's see what they do. Hello, emissary. Oh my goodness, look at that. Food shipments, exactly what we need. 260 food. 721 food, awesome. Now we can get training our troops. Let's get our gold shipments. Right now, there we go, another gold shipment and a gold shipment right there. So now we got some extra gold and some extra food. So now let's train up some of our slingers and spearmen. So let's see, let's get 5 spearmen and 5 slingers. We're going to finish up these troops training just for the sake of this video here, and let's go attack Babylonia here and win once and for all using our new slingers. So we have to go in with a whole new strategy here. So as you can see, this is how their base looks. And what we're gonna have to do, I think, is send them in from the front here and not really worry too much about the other tower until later on. Because they have all of those troops that come in to greet us. So we're gonna send all of them in right now. And we are just going to target that main area right there. Okay, so we attack that. Now we have to attack some of these different villagers that they have. So we're doing a pretty good job with the slingers. Basically, the spearmen were distracting them while the slingers came out. So now there are some more troops, so hopefully we can take those down. We still have to wait for the cooldown timer for our targeting to get into place. But as you can see, we are attacking some of these other buildings here and collecting a lot of food and gold. So one of the cool things is that targeting ability with the cooldown timer. Hopefully they add additional spells or potions or different things that you can apply to the game. But I definitely think the targeting is very useful. And it actually allows you to target buildings as opposed to in Boom Beach, where you have the flare, which will send them a certain area, and then the AI still kicks in. So we are attacking this little shrine over here, and we are also attacking some of their people that come out. They do have a lot of people defending, and I accidentally targeted one specific area, but I don't think it's going to be a huge deal. Wow, the slingers definitely have some great range on there, so those are definitely some very versatile troops there. They can really shoot far, and they seem to be doing a lot of damage. So we are pretty much almost done here. We just have to take down these walls and then attack this one last tower over there, and I think that was the best bet, going in from one side and saving the tower for the end, since it's not really in the vicinity of all of the other defenses and other buildings. We didn't have to worry about the tower for now. So they are going through. They have a whole nother wall to bust through, unfortunately, but actually it looks like they're just going straight for the tower, because the slingers can sling it right over the walls, right at the tower. So there we go. We just defeated and five-starred Babylonia. As you can see, we gained the additional loot that we didn't have before. We even had five surviving troops. So overall, I am really enjoying Domination. It is a great game. They are very generous on the amount of crowns that they gave out. It's really fun to go and explore the different areas. There's always something to do. If a little fox runs in, go in and hunt them. They even wave at you when you wave at them. Look at that. So it is a great game. I'm really enjoying it. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think of this game. If you enjoy it, do you think it's as good as Clash of Clans? Better than Clash of Clans? Its own game in its own right? Let me know in the comment section below. Do you want me to continue playing this game? Because I'm definitely enjoying it. There is a lot to do, and I really think this has the ability to become the next big game on the App Store. So let me know in the comment section below. I look forward to reading them. Be sure to check out App Man, which will let you get free iTunes gift cards, which you can use to get free crowns. It's that easy. So check out my tutorial, and be sure to check out my Clash of Clans videos. Be sure to subscribe so we can hit those milestones and give out free iTunes gift cards. That's right, free iTunes gift cards. Once again, I'm Alric from AppPlay. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.